mit Nick.
Hello guys, hello and welcome back to another episode. In this episode we're here. Where is here, you ask? It's Jefferson. Oh, it's a melee character. So melee character, we shoot his leg. So yeah, welcome back to another episode of Let's Fail at Fallout 3. I'm your host Madnik as always. And this guy is crippled. So our mission is to find Mr. Daddy. And to find Mr. Daddy, we need to come here to Jefferson Memorial. And here we are. This obviously will be filled with super mutants. Because, heck, why not, right? I mean, if we're here already, so why not take care of some super mutants, as they say. Adventure. Oh, 2 out of 9. 2 out of 9 villagers, maybe? Villagers. Sure. No, 3 out of 9. Sanctuary. Let's see. Yeah, I think that can fit. No, it cannot fit. No. Wait a minute, turret. Wait a minute. Carriages. 2 out of 9. Monitor, no. Uncovered, no. Bloody hell. I'm just guessing randomly. Because... Oh, never mind. Continued. Oh, there we go. 5 out of 9. 5 out of 9. Concerned. Oh, yeah. Come on. Deactivate turret. Thank you. I win turret, you lose. Yeah, that was inappropriate a little bit. I know. Oh, it's empty. Baseball. Okay. Got some ammo and a pistol as well. Sure, why not? I'll take it. I mean, if you're offering it, then yeah, why not, right? Vodka. Oh, some rounds. That's nice. Sorry. Hello there, Freddy Fears, House of Scares. Blah blah blah. Is there someone there? Hello? It's a red dot. Not sure where it came from. You'll be hunted. No, I'll miss. You'll be hunted. No, I'll miss. You'll be hunted. I'll miss again. Whoa. Wait a minute. Quick reload. Shoot its leg. Nice. Now I'll do this. Come on. Activate turret. Kill that. Ouch. Will you stop sliding, please? Nice. So the turret took that guy out. This is such a lol. Ouch! The turret is hitting me now. Will you die? Thank you. Deactivate. Okay. So turret is deactivated. Let's pump some thingies. That Satorium, whatever its name is. Santuar. Whatever, nobody cares. Doesn't have any loot, so nobody cares about him. Right? Right, so technically it's meant to be like a place where my father worked here or something like that. My memory serves me right, as they say. Basement. So I need to go to the basement? Rotunda. From what I remember though, I need to like rescue my father at some point and a manhole. And then we need to come back here. And then they tell me, please clean this place from all the blah 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 inside. So I was like, well, thinking to myself, right? If I'm gonna have to come back here and kill everything anyway, so why not do it right now, right? I mean, save some time for later, so to speak. If you know what I'm saying. Retunder. I just don't want to log off from any important sub basement. I want to stick at the same level to just clear it out completely, and then thinking about going to a different level or sub level, whatnot. You know, if you get my grift, of course. If you get my drift, man, it's a bit drifty. Whiskey. Sure, I'll take whiskey. So, I might consider the option that my father been an alcoholic. From me finding vodka and whiskey and whatnot here. So it's a gift shop, we've been here. There's nothing here. We've been in this room, but we haven't been in this room. Let's see what this room has to offer. Great pump something. Okay. Looks interesting enough. Let's see what's here. Oh, really? The wasteland. Fire control. Lock. Let me play. I cannot use this now. Alright. It's scripted for the thingy later on. Okay, well, at least we know it's here. Thingy. Plus, I have a flashing mark on my map. I should listen to it. Usually it does serve me right to show me the quest. Okay, well, we basically served this whole entire floor. And now we can... Is it blinking here? No, it's not. Okay. Let's go here. Oh, there we go. Rotunda. Let's see, red marking thingy. Oh no, you found me. Oh no. Will you be crippled? Yes, you will. Oh no, you found me. How can I sleep at night now? Oh, I'm stuck. Really? 24 bullets to your freaking chest and you're still alive? Really? Well... Holy shizzle man nizzle. I just cornered myself. Not a best option to deal with melee targets. Ouch. You know what? You know what? Okay. Okay. We're gonna have it your way then. Okay. I wanted to save that surprise for later on, but now that you're forcing me, I am obligated to use it. Don't say I didn't warn you, because I didn't. Okay? Just need... There you go. Come on. Come on, step on up. Koplowski. You're still alive, you little bugger. What the hell was that, man? Okay, I need a drink. I really need a drink. Okay. Okay. Oh, I need to read this one as well. Energy weapon increased by one. Okay, cool. Okay, so we need to go to that rotunda thingy. Good job. No, rotunda. Right. Rotunda place. Okay. No. Hello, hello? Can anybody hear me? Oh. 5, 8, 10. Listen to Dad's personal thingy, number 10. 8. Oh yeah, it's put off far. Okay. I'll try to maybe enter a code. Maybe. Not that I know what the code is, but you know. Just to check out my luck, whatever. So, okay. So we checked out this rotunda place. And I want to go check out the basement. I don't want to listen to the tapes just yet. Because if there are some tapes before the 5, 8, 10 tapes. Basement, basement, basement. There we go. I want to find them. I mean, if it's a tape marked as 5, number 5, that means there was 4 before and there should be 6 after. Right? That's my logic, in any case. But then again, I'm a failing idiot, so I might be wrong. Huh? What noise? What are you talking about? Thought there were maybe Meyer lurks again. Am I putting myself... Holy crap, your charge is incredibly strong, my friend. No, 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 I'm out of here. I am so out of here. Yeah, the pain, the pain. Ah, it's a monster. Right. Weapons. 52 damage. Okay. 50 damage. Well, 52 it is then. Darn it. Come on. Stick your head out. Oh, bloody hell. Okay. More, please. More, please. Oh, yes. Mysterious stranger. Where is he? Oh man, that was... Oh crap. That was brilliant. Mysterious stranger is by far, when it appears, the most overpowered thing ever. He can basically one-shot everything. And he does. Okay. Is that good? Is that good to have him? Problem is, it does not appear that as much as you want him to appear. Oh crap. Okay, one down, one to go. hope it's super normal super mutants and not some brutes or whatnot. Yeah, it's normal one. Okay. Nice. Okay. Now, you see, if I would have, like, Spirit of Death as a perk, which I'll have, darn it, next ding. Every time I kill someone with Vats, right, like I kill those two guys, my energy is fully restored. This door is not open because there is no power. Okay. At least I can check out this room. Where's my light? Where's my light? Okay. Let's just check out the rooms, you know. Whatever. And then listen to the tapes, I guess. Like I have any other choice. Right. There's like a vent there, or well, not a vent, but fan. Empty footlocker, empty footlocker, empty locker, empty footlocker. Bunk bed. Why there's no thing for me, guys? Oh, cabins. Sure, I'll take the packs, sigs. Some safe with some nothing in it. Brilliant. Flood control and something else. Check out something else first. Or should I go check out flood control first? I'll probably cannot use flood control because it'll tell me you have not enough power, blah 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 blah. Come on. You can do it. There we go. Is that a red stain on your face, or just very happy to see me? No, that's a red stain on your face. LOL! Okay. Some pistol. Oh. No, it's crap. It's crap. Alright, I've been there. I haven't been here. Or have I? Yeah, I have been here. That's where I came from. Right, so flood control. Right away, some ammo. And a pistol that I can repair. Sensor models. Sure, I'll take those. Whatever. Oh, vodka. Don't we all just love vodka? I mean, I know I don't. Don't you? Well, it's not that I don't like vodka, I just don't drink it. But okay. Oh, there we go. Okay. There you go, I said that there might be something else. My logic was true. Better days. Scotch. Empty bottle of whiskey. Wow, he was drinking quite a lot, man. Okay, let's sleep a very good hour. And let's listen to what our daddy has to say, basically. Okay, where do we start? Project Portal. One second. What do we have here? We have this one. We have this one. Yeah. Some security password, storage, room, maintenance. Scheme of railway, rifle. So I can make a railroad rifle, whatever. I have a box code for Rayleigh, whatever. Yeah. come on. DCTA map. Cannot see. Yeah, bounty for Madnik. Tech museum loot. Museum gun locker. Oh! Really? Wait a minute, I'd like to request that all Riot gear and security firearms move to the new gun locker in the Planetarium Research Office. It should remain locked at all time. The key to the cabinet must be carried by the duty shift supervisor and left in the security office safe when shift changes occur and closing times. Okay. So I should have read it when I was there. Never mind. And the weapon cache enclosed. You'll find the coordinates to military weapon cache that has uncovered in Hamilton's hideaway. Yeah. Install logs. Keep up the good fight. Copperhead. Okay. Thank you, Copperhead. Let's listen.
Well, here we are again. Project Purity and me. It's been close to 20 years since my last entry, as I left all of this behind to make a life for my son. We've spent that time in Vault 101, tucked away from the rest of the world. It wasn't perfect, but it was safe, and that's all I could have hoped for. Now my son is a grown man, handsome, intelligent, confident. Just like his old man. And as hard as it was to admit it, he doesn't need his daddy anymore.
Right, one second. I don't know if it will help or not. Again. I won't play it, I'll just adjust it and do some editing.
So here I am, back where it all began. Project Purity. God, we wanted to change the world. We really thought the waters of life could be a reality. And that's why this is a momentous occasion. Because even after 19 years, I still believe it. Project Purity can and will be operational. This is just the beginning. This is day two of my attempt to resurrect this project. I've got one of the portable fusion generators up and running, but it's just enough to power the emergency lighting and a couple of other systems. That will serve for now, but I'll need help powering up the mainframe. Time to visit Madison at Rivet City. I spoke with Dr. Lee Madison at Rivet City. It went about as well as I expected. That is to say, she thinks I'm completely mad. How can I blame her? She's got her own life, her own team, and is making real, tangible scientific progress. Here I come again, the very paragon of failure and false promises. But the reality is, I need Madison and whatever scientific team she may have assembled. I can't do this myself. Project Purity is bigger than me. It always was. And without Catherine, God, I can't let this die. Not again. Not like this.
Okay. So now we don't have part 4. At least I couldn't find part 4, as you could see. Unless I missed something. But whatever. Let's fail. So part 5, guys. Entry 5.
Even in Vault 101, my work on Project Purity never really stopped. Soon after we arrived, my nightly routine included sneaking into the restricted areas, searching for, I don't know, whatever I could find. It was a Vault-Tec facility, after all. The place was built with some of the most advanced technology this country had ever developed. Those excursions never turned up anything particularly useful. So, one night, after half a bottle of scotch, I broke into the overseer's office. It was easy enough to hack his console, gain access to the restricted files. Most of it was garbage. Propaganda, spy reports, just plain rambling bullshit, really. But there was one thing, one name that stood out amongst all the others. Dr. Stanislaus Braun. I knew of Braun's work, of course. He was a celebrity in his day, Voltaic's sorcerer scientist, leaving his peers in awe of his technological wizardry. But it was in Vault 101 that night in the overseer's office. I first learned of Braun's involvement in Voltaic's social preservation program and his work on something called GEC, the Garden of Eden creation kit.
Now, a GEC, I don't know if you know or not, but GEC is a big, big, huge deal in the Fallout series of games. I mean, it was one of the... It's the most important mission. It's what Fallout 2 is evolved around. I mean, you have like a limited time to get a GEC for your own tribe, right? I mean, you do whatever you want in the game, but if you fail to bring the GEC in time, then you fail the game. That's it. So a GEC is a very big deal. So yeah, parts entry 6 and 7 we don't have, and 9 we won't have either. And we don't have at the moment, so just listen to 8 and 10. And by the way, if you don't know, but the voice of the father that speaks right now is Liam Neeson. And if you don't know who Liam Neeson is, you should check him out. Just go to IMDb. He's a very famous actor, by the way. IMDb.com. Type Liam Neeson, you'll find him. Right, let's listen.
To be honest, the GEC sounded like pure fantasy, even for someone of Braun's capabilities. It was nothing short of a miracle. A terraforming module capable of producing life from complete lifelessness. But not only was this thing a reality, it was actually distributed to several vaults to be used after an atomic war. Vault 101 was, sadly, not on that list. I did some digging and discovered Braun's name on the reservation list for a Vault 112. I'm no slouch, but this man, he could have easily succeeded where I failed. Does his collected knowledge remain within the halls of Vault 112? Journals, holotapes, computer records, maybe even experiments. If I could gain access to just a fraction of Braun's genius, Project Purity would become a reality. I'm off to Vault 112 to search for anything of Braun's that might help me get this purifier up and running. All I know is that it's west of some place called Evergreen Mills, and it's well hidden in some sort of garage. But I'll find it. I have to. It's so close, but that's the story of Project Purity, isn't it? An eternity of almost theirs. Let's see if Braun has the missing puzzle piece.
Okay, let's listen to Better Days, guys.
That batch of tests was inconclusive, but Madison and I are convinced it's a problem with the secondary filtration system. We're going to recalibrate the equipment and try again tomorrow, so that... James, please, I'm trying to work. Now's not the time. So that's the next step. Assuming we get the results we need, we'll move on to... James! Stop! I need to finish these notes. We'll move on to diagnosing the issues with the radiation dampeners. That should... Ow! James! Now? We really shouldn't.
Right. And in that night, our character was conceived. Okay. So, now that we know the mission, we should get the heck out of here. Go to some place... Not here, basically. Just hide the weapon so we could... Wait a minute. So we could run faster. Yeah, mainframe, whatever. Okay. Right. I'm sorry, I am a little bit afraid that my room space, the space that I have on my computer might run out, so a little bit anxious to check what's what. Never mind, it seems that it's pretty good for now, I think. Let's see, world map, where is it? Oh, it's there. What is this? Fort Independence. Vault 106. You know what? Let's go to Tenpenny Tower. Yeah. I'll get some ammo and stuff like that. And next episode, we'll go to that place. Etc. So yeah, thank you for joining so far, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you will join me at the next part, guys. Thank you, and bye-bye.